Dear friends, respected Commissioner of Police Pune, Dr. Satyapal Singh, other police officers, and my colleague directors. Today we have a very distinguished guest, Dr. Satyapal Singh, Commissioner of Police Pune. Dr. Singh, an officer of the 1980 IPS batch, he did his MSc Chemistry and MPhil Chemistry. He has done his MBA from Australia, and at the same time, he is an MA and Doctorate in Public Administration. Dr. Singh, who has received the President's Police Medal for the Distinguished Service in 2004, Police Medal for Meritorious Service by President 1996, and DG's Insignia 1996. He was the Commissioner of Nagpur Police, and prior to that, for 4 years, he was Special Inspector General of Police of Konkan Range. He has also been deputed to CBI. He also has a Special Service Medal for working in Naxalite areas. He worked as Chairman of Committee for drawing SOP, Standards Operating Procedure for Coastal Police Stations, and the Chairman of Maharashtra State Committee to Tackle Cybercrime. On behalf of Sri Balaji Society, I welcomed Dr. Satyapal Singh to our campus.
Brigadier Sri Bhambani, all the distinguished personalities on the dais, my DCP, Dr. Mahesh Patil, other officers, faculty, and my dear students. At the outset, I am grateful to the college authorities for giving us this time slot so that we could share our thoughts with you. Today I did not come here to have the felicitation, but I could not say no also at the last minute. I am here today after this tragic, very, very sad incident which happened on 13th of February, wherein we lost 11 lives, all young, except one Italian lady. She was 37 years old. All other 10 were between 18 to 26. Out of the 60 injured, most of them are young. Why did it happen? Can we prevent such kind of a terrorist incident? You are all, I am told you are all management student. Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
You are being told, what is management? What is management? When something goes wrong, we again review our planning, where we failed. Did we really fail? Whether the police failed, the city failed, the bakery failed, or the young lives who lost forever, they failed. Who lost? Who failed? Can we do something about it? That is the management. And that is the lesson of life. How to save lives? You have such a beautiful, perhaps one of the best auditorium I have seen in Pune. And as your Brigadier General was telling me, one of the best institute having such a good discipline. What kind of discipline in life we should follow? The first and foremost requirement of life is, human being is, that we must be safe and secure. If we are not safe, we are not secure, there is no use having the MBA degrees. Becoming a management professional, becoming engineer, becoming professor, it is of no use. The first lesson of the management is, let us be safe and secure. If we are safe and secure, we can be progressive. Otherwise, we cannot be progressive. We will be innovative. If we are sick, we cannot be innovative. In our day-to-day life, we face so much of problem that we can't be sure about ourselves, we can't be sure about our brothers, our sisters, our relations. Innovation will vanish. On the roads, almost every day in the country, we lose around more than 1 lakh lives on the roads. In Maharashtra, in particular, we lose around 12,000 people every day on the roads. In a year. Roads do not have accidents. We have some rules. In the city, we have traffic light, traffic signals. But you know the crowd, especially the young crowd. If there is no policeman, what will happen? They don't want to follow the traffic signals. If you don't follow the traffic signals, it will result into more and more accidents. When there are more and more accidents, we lose lives. Perhaps in the same way, there are some basic disciplines in life, basic rules in life. If you want to be safe and secure, if you want to be healthy, can any doctor in the world can give you guarantee? You have the liberty to do whatever you want to do. Drink, eat, enjoy the life. But I will not let you fall sick. Have you ever come across a doctor like this? Is there any professor available? Whether you attend the class or not, whether you listen to the teachers or not, but I will ensure that you will pass in first division. Is there any professor available like this? There is no teacher available like this. When there is no doctor available like this, when there is no teacher available like this, similarly, you cannot get a policeman, traffic police corps available to you who can ensure you drive the way you like on the roads, but I will ensure you will never meet an accident. It's just not possible. What really happened on the 13th evening? I don't know how many of you, because it's a very popular joint for young people. How many of you have visited this German bakery? Oh, a large number, right? I was also not knowing it is so popular. But after this tragic incident, I came to know even my daughter and my son-in-law, they also visited at General Bakery. Because my son-in-law also passed out from Pune. He was also here for 5 years. So he was also knowing about the General Bakery. On that day, it's a very small place, you know. Around 70 people were there inside. Some people, they were waiting outside on the roads, waiting for the table to get empty for them. Yesterday only I got one letter from a German. He wrote a letter to me. He has not informed any authorities. Yesterday only he sent the letter to me that on that day, at the time of the blast, I was waiting to get a table, but there was no place to sit. So I purchased something and I was just standing on the road. And I also got injured. But being myself a doctor, I myself did some first aid and immediately I rushed to my house. But at a small place, many people might be standing, I don't know. Somebody came. Somebody! Might be one, might be two, might be four, we don't know as of now. The terrorists, they are faceless people. Faceless. Nobody comes. Written on their forehead that I am a terrorist. Nobody would say. They are just like us. Somebody came with a backpack. Many of the students carry like this bag. And you know in this Pune city, might be 3 to 4 lakh students, young students are there. There are more than around 18,000 foreign students studying in this city. Just think about it. But the population of students are so large. Is it possible for the police to check each and everyone? Or is it advisable to check each and everyone? Screen each and everyone? What you are carrying on your back? Because quantity not much, but use not much. Experts believe it could be around 1 kg or so. Not much. But what really happened? This terrorists, they came with a bag. They must have their cup of tea or coffee, whatever they had. And while leaving the place, they left over their bag below the table. Nobody noticed it. The five persons, five young lives, 3 girls and 2 boys, who just came and immediately occupied the table, they also did not notice that there is a bag below the table. I don't know. We are not sure how many minutes passed. It might be 10 minutes, it might be 15 minutes. Might be 8 minutes, we do not know. After some minutes, somebody, or might be one of them who had occupied that table, they noticed, they told to the waiter that there is some bag has been left over here. He went and told to each cashier, ki log aise shikayat kar rahe hain, wahan par koi bag pada hai. Kaiser was busy in counting the cases because there was so much of crowd. Kaiser also forgot for a few minutes. Then somebody again reminded him. Then he asked the other waiter, "Main ja karke pata karo bag kidhar hai?" We are not sure, or we almost, I am 99% sure, that waiter also did not touch the bag and this bag exploded or the glass shattered. Had it been noticed, had the young crowd having that kind of security consciousness, and somebody came here, and all the persons, these persons or the waiter, these persons came here with a bag, are they just going away without the bag, leaving the bag away, here only? Why? But the persons who occupied the table, even before sitting, they should have noticed it. They also did not notice it. Waiter did not notice it. The bakery did not have the I should not call it paraphernalia, but basic minimum security measures. And it resulted into this, such a tragic incident. I am here to suggest to you not to feel that just because of this once bomb blast, Pune city has become safe, unsafe. No. Just like that, as accidents take place on the roads, we cannot say the roads have become totally unsafe and we will not drive on the road. Life will not go that way. It's just not possible. But I wish you, every one of you would like to wish that it should be the first and the last blast case in the Pune. Would you all like?
Yes, sir.
What should we do for it? We must follow certain basic precautions. What are those guidelines? Your brigadier was telling me that institute is having one temple. What is the temple? Siddhi Vinayak temple, Ganpati temple. What is the message of Ganpati? Ganpati is not simply a goat. It is not just the lord of Ganpati. You are the student, all the students of management. Does it signify something else? Vegan Artha? Yes, it is Vegan Artha. Vegan Karthi Artha? I don't know how many of you have studied history. Kuch logon ne to padhi hogi. There was a history of Somnath Temple. Very famous Somnath Temple. Dekha hai kya kuch logon ne? Bahut achhi jagah hai. Who looted Somnath Temple? Are Gori nahi, Ghazni, Ghaznavi. He came from Ghazni, Ghaznavi. Which year? Pardon? 17 times, which year? 1192. That was Mohammad Gori and Prithviraj Chauhan fight. Battle. Okay, keep on thinking about it. You refresh your memory later on. According to me, it is 1025. Okay, but that is not very material. Material point is, when Mohammad Ghaznavi attacked this temple was having 1200 soldiers, fighters, army men. How many? 1200. They were ready to fight. They were trained to fight. But what really happened? वहां के जो ब्राह्मण पंडित पुजारी जो लोग थे वहां का जो हेड प्रिस्ट था he told the army, there is no need to fight. Why? शिवजी भगवान, शिवजी भगवान ने अपना तीसरा नेत्र अगर खोल दिया तो महमूद गजनवी की सारी सेना जो है धराशायी हो जाएगी. नो नीड टू फाइट, नो नीड टू रेज योर वेपन्स. Nobody did it. And you know what happened? It was razed. Somnath temple was razed to the ground. It was looted. So much of wealth was looted. Very interesting story if you read history. So much of wealth, so much of diamond, so much of gold was there. They looted. After that, many of these soldiers, they were also caught. They were made prisoners. And they were sold in the markets of Ghazni as slaves. They were sold as slaves. Shivji Maharaj ne kuch kiya nahi. Do aankh to khol ke rakhe the, teesra bhi nahi khola. Ganpati is Vegan Artha. How is Vegan Artha? If you follow his message, if you follow his lessons, if you follow his directive, then it is Vegan Artha. Then your Vegan will go away. What is the message? Keep your eyes always open just like Ganpati. Have you seen any Ganpati with closed eyes? You will not find. Keep your eyes always open. Wherever you go, whether you walk on the roads, whether you go for the shopping, whether you go to see, to watch a movie, in malls, in multiplexes, wherever you go, when you, even you hire a taxi, even you hire a auto rickshaw, see around. whether something suspicious is there, whether something suspicious person is sitting around, talking around. This Ganpati has very big ears. What for? What you cannot see, try to hear. Try to hear the changed conversation. Try to listen to this unusual conversation. Who are these persons who are talking about terrorism? Who are these persons who are dividing the society in the name of the religion, in the name of the society, in the name of the caste and creed? Who are these persons who talk? If you do something, if you die in the name of religion, heaven or jannat or swarg is waiting for you. Who are these persons? Who are the persons who have become the merchants of hate? Who have become the sponsors of intolerance in the society? Who are these vested interests? Be careful about them. Let us believe in one humanity. Let us believe only in one religion, the religion of humanity. Let us believe only in one country, just one patriotism. This country belongs to us, we belong to it. We have to protect it, we have to defend it. And just like Ganpati, his nose is so long, try to smell the danger from a distance. It signifies that. That is a lesson of management. Ganpati is a management guru. Learn from him. See his big belly. What for this big belly is sown? Big belly means collect through your eyes, through your ear, through your nose, collect all kinds of information. Keep in your belly. But see it according to requirement. What resource is required where? In which branch, in which manager, share according to need, according to requirement. Don't keep everything with you yourself, just like a belly, just like the stomach. It eats, it's turned into everything. In the juices, all kinds of juices, and ultimately into blood, but supplies to all parts of the body. Share it. Share with the consent. I am not here to suggest to you. Just keep on collecting information. Go after collection of information. But whatever you observe, with your eyes, with your ears, who are the persons going to the cyber cafes and misusing it? Who is every day going and all kinds of jihadi sites or so-called fundamentalist sites on the internet? You could keep these basic things. Fortunately, you have the merchant club here in this college. Inform your teacher, inform your parents. Inform the police, if you could. Because, you know, as I mentioned earlier in this German bakery case, few minutes delay, just few minutes delay, it costs so dear to us. There is a very famous saying in Hindi, कुछ ऐसे भी मंजर हैं, कुछ ऐसे भी मंजर हैं तारीख की नजरों में. तारीख means history. तारीख means history. उर्दू का पढ़ रहे हो. तारीख means history. कुछ ऐसे भी मंजर हैं, कुछ ऐसे भी इंसिडेंट हैं, कुछ ऐसे भी इंस्टेंसेस हैं, कुछ ऐसे भी मंजर हैं तारीख की नजरों में. लम्हों ने खता की, लम्हों ने खता की और सदियों ने सजा पाई. लम्हों ने खता की. Few seconds, few minutes delay. You know, you ask the value of second. Who is a sprinter? Who is a runner? They can tell you the value of 1 minute. Their lives are lost like this. Every minute is important. Every minute is important in the examination hall. So every minute is important for life. Every minute is important if you want to remain safe. Please remember this. Whenever you notice anything, any suspicious person, any suspicious item, any abandoned vehicles where you think it could be harmful to the society. Because today it could be others, tomorrow you could be in the same position. Let us develop that brotherhood. Let us develop that social feelings for everyone. And this message should be spread all around. Whatever you are listening here today, keep on discussing, spreading with your friends, with your family members, because it is not only confined to Pune. Terrorism today has become a global problem. It is not to particular religion. It is not to particular caste. All religions, many all religions, in one way or the other, they follow this kind of this extremism or extremist thoughts. You must be knowing in this today, as you study, the multinationals, the trans corporations, how to manage trans corporations, how to manage multinationals, how multinationals are being managed today. You know the role of multinationals. They recruit in one country, they train, they train in another country, they must be raising the fund in third country, or they must be producing in fourth country, or they must be marketing in fifth country. Same thing is happening with terrorism today. They plan and conceive the plan, they raise the fund, might be in second country, they are recruiting from all over the world. You never know. They must be getting them recruited or getting recruited or trained in another country, or they are targeting some other country. Terrorism has really become a global problem. So we require, just like in the arena of management, we require a global manager. To tackle this terrorism, we require global thinking, global coordination, international coordination. I'm sure with these ideas, you are the 3D. Your brigadier was telling me you are 3D. 3Ds. What are the 3Ds? Discipline, dedication, and determination. If you do not have the discipline, you cannot be determined. If you do not have the discipline, you cannot be dedicated. I will add one more D to it. And fourth D is it is called Dena Siko. D means done. I don't know what is English. Donation kah sakte. Okay. I am only requesting, I am making an appeal to you all. Please keep on spreading this light around. Who can do it? One who is not himself is not, or herself is not disciplined. You may fall prey to this kind of thing. Every day, morning and evening, you must pray to God, I have to be safe. If you have to be safe, if you have to be healthy, if you have to be a good management expert, every day, morning and evening, you must have your vision in front of you. You must have the mission. I don't know what is the difference between mission and vision. because many management professors I have also found confused about it. And today I am not here to speak on management. I speak on management also. I speak on leadership. I speak on communications. I myself is a student of management. But today I am not here to speak on management. I am only requesting you. Be safe. Share these ideas with your friends, your family members. And take a determination today. Have a resolution today. Yes, I will not allow this, my city, this city of culture, this city of peace, this city of education, to fall prey to such kind of the terrorist incidents. With these words, I end here. I again thank the college authorities for allowing me to come in your midst. Thanks, and all the best to you. God bless you all.
Good afternoon, sir. This is Rakesh Parida from Bhubaneswar. My question is, as you are providing a unique identity card to the students, can you provide us different training, like how to capture a fully armed terrorist, or how to use several weapons, by which we will not just work as an informer, we'll work and can be used as a suitable and immediate asset for police and society as and when required?
Very difficult question you are asking me. I think an innovative question you have, very well taken. Perhaps it is not practically possible. But as far as police is concerned, I am not here to tell that police has abdicated its responsibility. But police strength in the city, as I mentioned earlier, is very less. That is why we are creating this awareness. See, even identity card, they can be forged. And there are many instances like this. Even this, what do you call it, the income tax? PAN card, voter's cards, ration card, motor driving license card, even degree, you know? Recently, about just 15 days back, we got a letter from CBI. The case is going on in the High Court, Mumbai. Around 740, how many? 740. Number exact, thoda gadbad ho sakta hai. 700 exact, around gudra. Medical mention 700. But if I remember correctly, around 748 or something like this. These are the degrees and diplomas of University of Pune only. No other private university, no other deemed university. Ye Bharati Vidya Pit or Symbiosis, unki baat nahi kar raha hu main. I am talking only about University of Pune, which have been forged, and many of these so-called students or candidates, whatever you call them, I don't call them students, they gave to the companies where they wanted employment. IT companies, very big multinational companies, and they were found to be forged and duplicate. So in this country where morality has gone so down, where life values, human values have gone so down, unfortunately our education has gone so down. We keep on teaching management, we keep on teaching mathematics, we keep on teaching language, but we do not teach the basic things of life. And that is the pain of the modern society. Let me take another question, one or two. Thank you.
Sir, every time, why do we realize that terrorism is happening only when we see a blast? Because nowadays, one of the common problems that we are facing, I think all of us would agree, is that nearby our college area itself, every now and then students are being harassed by the Marathis. You know, there are people beaten up, all, isn't this a form of terrorism? How can we just look out for bags? How can we just look out for bombs? I mean, we can't really, feel that, okay, this person might just come up and harass me, but just because I do not belong to the state. So how far can we save ourselves from this?
Very sad question you have asked. And I have all my sympathy with you and all your friends. I am also an outsider in that way. Unfortunate, it is very unfortunate that in the name of this country has made many mistakes, though I don't want to speak on that. Sometimes I do speak. In the name of language, in the name of religion, in the name of caste, when he starts dividing the society, that shows the downfall of the society. That shows we are not really educated. We have become so selfish. When we are not competent, बोलते हैं अंगूर ऊपर के खट्टे हैं इसलिए मुझे मिल नहीं रहे. When we are not able to get something, we start blaming others. But as far as the first part of the question is, it's not that we come to know to the reality that terrorism has come to the country. No, it is not that. It's not that it has come first time to the city. It is not that. I don't know. Most of you must be carrying their cell phone, mobile phones. And we keep on sending through mobile companies, please, be alert, remain alert. Be alert about the suspicious person's vehicle. We keep on sending these kind of the messages. We keep on taking the message. We keep on getting the inputs also from intelligence agencies. Yes, Pune could be one of the targets. No city in the world can claim, yes, we are immune to terrorism. No city can claim. Yes, I mentioned just like these road accidents. No city can claim in that way. The only solution is that we have to be alert and we must all get unitedly against this so-called, this hydra-headed monster. Is it a monster? It is a disease called contagious disease. It is spreading. You know, about 10 years back, there used to be around 80 jihadi sites on the internet. Today, today there are around 1,200 jihadi sites available on the internet. Everything is, what is happening to this world? Only solution is that we must have only one religion. Religion of humanity and religion of patriotism. Then only we can face this challenge. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for such an enriching awareness session. Sir, as you say, remaining alert is our religion, making others aware is our mission. Your guidance will surely equip and motivate us to be alert and responsible citizens of the city.